I think we are defining the language of mobile cinema at the moment, and so within my research I have sort of very much engaged with this sort of new idea of a mobile moving image practice. And I made a publication with some colleagues from UK, with Camille and Kasia, who are interactive artists and fine artists, and they also work with smartphones. And so I think what we can see is we can see a practice, an aesthetic that is very specific to mobile media. And so, of course, with smartphones, the very interesting thing is that there is a development of tools, there's development of apps, and so we get a bit of a continuous innovation that is now becoming more ubiquitous. But I think these very early aesthetics, they paved the way for something that we can now see as a very much mobile characteristic. And some of these qualities, they are very much intimate and immediate. Well, I think it's the idea is, if you think back, right, when there was suddenly typewriters, not everyone was a typewriter, is a poet. But what I can see is there were some filmmakers from the French New Wave that thought that the camera is that the camera stylo, so that Astruc thought there will be a camera soon that will be small as a pen, and that you can write visual images with this pen. And I think now, if you think about what we've got in our pockets, I think this is like almost like a visual pen. So what I can see is that there is on one side communication in general is becoming more visual, and that we now attach some cinematic languages to communication. But at the same time, what for me is very important at the moment in my work is to think about what we call development of digital literacies, also visual literacies, is that to engage people and make them, inspire them, that they can take the phone out and understand how they can make a movie. So there is this little gap of, you know, take the phone out and make a movie. But I think once you know some of these basic ideas of some ideas of filmmaking and what we discussed earlier, some of the mobile characteristics, I think lots of us can become filmmakers. And some people would argue that it is a democratization of media, and I hope it will happen at one point. I think film consumption is a very interesting point at the moment. So what I'm very interested in at the moment is to think about some of these things that are, you know, emerged in the space of transmedia storytelling, cross-media production, and really the dissemination of content through smartphones as well as like social media. And I think mobile technologies take a very interesting position in that, what I call mediascape. So it's a landscape that is made up of media, but I think the smartphone is really a medium that can connect all these different nodes that we have around. And so there's been some very interesting projects that happened that that also now some broadcasters realize that there is a space for transmedia storytelling. And so I think we will see more of these practices happening. So I think there will always be sort of, you know, traditional formats of film, TV, but even these projects becoming to realize that they can embed some more collaborative practices, or even some more mobile phone filmmaking practices. So I think it's opening up of like a, what some people have called a third screen next to the bigger ones. Well, I think what I tried to talk in my presentation, if there would have been more time, I really would have liked to think about some very precise definitions of these words that we use these days, which are collaboration, participation, co-creation. Then I think if you look back into some of these trajectories, how we come to this point now, I think we can, for instance, think about collaboration that has that artists have done in in the last 20-40 years, where they have made a public artworks. And I think some of these aesthetics of collaboration that some of these artists have defined are very interesting for now working in a social media space. So it's not about reinventing the wheel, but, you know, thinking for me always about some of these early forms. And for me, one of the key projects, actually, if you go even back further in history, is in the 1920s when Giga Bertov, he made films with people on trains. I mean, of course, he had a very much a political motivation for this, and that's how he was funded to make his films, but I think he was really an artist that wanted to make work. And if I think about this, that people made films on trains going through a big country and then making films with people in one village, developing on the train and showing it in the next village, and I think that is what we can do with social media now. So yeah, there is a big corporate machinery that tries to develop these tools, but what I've seen happening in the past so fast is that they don't conceptually really understand it, because sometimes business models aren't really sustainable, and so the big corporate is interested in how do we sell lots of mobile phones, you know. So I mean, of course, we have to understand, because that's how they make their living, you know. But what I find very interesting is that now they try to sell all these phones. It means, okay, they will be coming out to the world. We can do new things with these things, and I think that is a space where we can make some change happening, because visual media, I think, is a very powerful discourse that allows us to create some new languages, but also, you know, engaging more people. And some people might say, oh, social media, that's just rubbish and you don't know what to do, but I think if you know how to find the good stuff and giving more people a voice, if you give it some time, it will be an avenue that will have some quite defined prospects. Muchas gracias por la invitación, es muy genial, es chévere, es las gentes creativos, exhibiciones, es un ciudad very creative, and talking with lots of people, new amigos, making new friends, and lots of discussions on what is happening at the moment in Manizales, Colombia, but also internationally, is for me really wonderful. And I will go back to New Zealand with lots of new ideas, which is for me, and connections as well, which is for me quite amazing. So, muchas gracias.